Dear students, this slide contains about mechanical transmission system where the power is to be transmitted or motion is to be transmitted from one to another, means rotary to linear or linear to rotary motion. The main two types are there. The image you can see here, ball screw or recirculating ball screw type one, and then rack and pinion. These two are main the elements which are used in the CNC machine, and few torque transmitting elements such as belt pulley, timing belt pulley, gearbox, couplings, etc. So in the ball screw type, the rotary is converted into linear motion. It comes of a third edge shaft in which the balls are circulated, spiral raceway for the ball bearings, which acts as a precision screw, and these can withstand the higher thrust loads also with minimum internal friction. They are made to close tolerances and are therefore suitable for using situations in which high precision is necessary. The ball assembly or the recirculating screw assembly consists of say nut and threaded shaft. Threaded shaft is the screw and the nut is slides or rotates over the threaded shaft. This threaded shaft, there are two types according to the start of the pitch of the thread. So they are like this, just for the reference. It is the views you can see, single start and double start. How the balls are say rolled or circulated over the threads of the shaft. So lead is equal to pitch. If L is equal to P, then it is a single start. Or in double start, the two times lead is equal to two times of the pitch. So in this slide, a flexible coupling you can see. The image you can see here. And as far as the diagram it is concerned, this you can take off. Say these couplings you may be knowing to join the two shafts, okay, driven and driving. So these couplings are used when the driver and driven shafts are coaxial. Flexibility built into the couplings to compensate misalignment errors like radial, angular or axial alignment. So since it is difficult to align the driver and driven shafts perfectly on the same axis, so the heat and elastic deformation cause additional misalignments between the two coaxial shafts. So therefore, to build flexibility, the flexible couplings are used as shown in the figure. The servo motors and the screw, ball screw, are directly coupled by these couplings. So the next one is the transmission system, the timing belts. Separately, the timing belt, the name is given, it's an endless belt which is having the teeth, contains teeth, and which sets over the pulley, which is having the same the profile of as for the belt. So perfectly it is set on the pulley. So in that sense it is called as a timing belt. So they match the profile of the belt, match perfectly with the pulley, the teeth on the pulley. So initial tension will be set over the pulleys so as to get the necessary working or performance or say tightness, we can call. So that depends the setting of the tension in the belts depending upon the power and the speed to be transmitted. So advantages of this say transmission, you can say rotary to rotary with the previous other transmission system is say low cost, noiseless, lubrication is not required, very minimum maintenance, then efficiency is good, positive drive, etc.